So composition scheme section 10, kind of important section because it got lot of amendments. Okay, and don't read this scheme from your module. It is first request from my side. Read it from CA module. Okay, composition levy section 10. What is composition scheme? This is the first point we are going to discuss, and we had already discussed. It is simplified alternative scheme. One is normal scheme where you have to comply with all provisions of GST law, you have to maintain books of account, you have to file monthly return, payment monthly. So it is burdensome for small dealers. Government have created alternative scheme for small traders and manufacturers. Alright. So this is alternative scheme for payment of taxes and filing of return. A composition taxpayer is not required to maintain, okay, elaborative records. Okay, he don't have to maintain elaborative record, detailed records, some basic records are enough. Second point, the objective of composition scheme is to bring simplicity in tax compliances, which was burdensome in original law. Okay, composition taxpayer is not required to issue tax invoice. He cannot issue tax invoice because I told you the reason, he cannot pass on GST credit, input tax credit, he cannot pass on. So which document he will prepare is bill of supply. Okay, so bill of supply. Turnover limit we have discussed yesterday for special category state and for special category state, 8 out of special category only 8 states are here. What are those 8 states? Arunachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland and Sikkim and Tripura. Tripura, what was your
Suman.
Suman, but then
Suman.
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 S-U-M-A-N-T. S-U-M-A-N-T.
M-3.
Then Tripura?
T-T is Tripura.
Okay, A-3. Suman.
M-3.
M
is Tripura.
Oh, sorry. So Suman is right, okay? So some students have advised me to write it as a Suman. So they can remember they are same with this particular. We also try to remember in the same way. Some older student they had put maths na, so every student have their own choice of putting some abbreviation. So this is the abbreviation we are following for this batch. S stands for Sikkim, U stands for Uttarakhand, M have three words, that is Mizoram, Manipur, Meghalaya. Alright, so that is three. A is Arunachal Pradesh, very to put a lot of emphasis on Arunachal Pradesh because A stands for Assam also, but Assam is here. Okay, that is for clear. Assam, Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir, I repeated at least 5 times, and rest of India is here on 1.5 category. Okay, N is Nagaland and T is Tripura. These states are in 75 categories and balance whole India including Assam, Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir is in 1.5 crore categories. This turnover we are not checking from current year, this turnover we are checking from previous year. Because if my last year turnover is less than 1.5 crore, then only I am eligible in current year. Am I clear? So if I am going to put turnover like this, my last year turnover is 1.35 crore. Am I eligible?
No.
No. I am talking about normal India. Am I eligible?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
But if I am in Meghalaya, Mizoram here, my turnover is 60 lakh. Am I eligible?
Yes.
Yes. 70 lakh. Am I eligible?
Yes.
Yes. Now, can I ask you one advanced level doubt?
Yes.
Okay. I have two branches. One branch in Mumbai and one branch in Nagaland. Hello?
Yes.
One branch in Mumbai and one branch in Nagaland. Now, I'm going to ask two, three different questions on this. First of all, am I making interstate supply?
Yes.
Because if you are making interstate supply, you are not eligible for scheme. This scheme is only for small dealers. Small dealers mean dealer who deals in that state itself.
Yes.
Okay. So if I have one shop in
Mumbai
and one shop in Nagaland, am I making interstate supply?
No,
I am not making interstate supply. I have multi-state business.
Yes.
I have business in Maharashtra and I have business in Nagaland. I must have taken registration in Nagaland. I must have taken registration in Maharashtra. It is not interstate supply. Nagaland branch sells only in Nagaland and Mumbai branch sells only in Mumbai. So therefore, I am eligible from that perspective. Am I clear?
Yes.
This is the one doubt that student usually ask.
Yes.
Okay, so this doubt is clear. Having multi-state business is not a problem. Doing multi-state business is, doing interstate business is a problem. If you are doing interstate transaction, then you are not eligible for schemes. Hello? Am I clear? Second. What is the turnover limit now for me? Okay, one, before that I will ask one more doubt. Okay? Can I go like this? I will take composition scheme only for Maharashtra and normal scheme for Nagaland. Can I choose this? Because registrations are separate. Although SSC is common, but registration are separate. Can I select like this? Maharashtra only, composition and Nagaland in normal scheme? Answer is no. Okay? That note will come. Once you select composition scheme, you have to select for all business registration of the same person. GST registration is a pan-based registration. GST registration is pan-based. And one person cannot have multiple pan. See, one person can have multiple GST registration. Every state different GST registration. But my pan will be common. You can see here also, aggregate turnover we look. Hello? Can you see? Person having same pan to be computed on all India basis. All India basis means you are getting this. While checking eligibility, I am not checking eligibility for Maharashtra separate and Nagaland separate. I am checking eligibility for India level basis. Hello, if I have turnover 1 crore in Maharashtra, 1 crore in Gujarat, 1 crore in Tamil Nadu. So statewide I am having less than 1.5 crore every state.
Yes.
Am I eligible?
No.
No, why? My total turnover is? My aggregate turnover on India basis is 3 crore. So I am eligible or not eligible?
No.
Then if you see statewide I am eligible.
Yes.
But I am not a small dealer. No, I am earning 3 crore rupees. I am having turnover of 3 crore rupees. If I am having three state business. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. So they say you don't check eligibility on state level. You have to check eligibility on all India level. Am I clear?
Yes.
So can I go for some state composition and some state normal? Reply to this now again?
No.
If I have to select composition, I have to select composition pan-based. Pan-based means?
Whole
India. Okay. All branches, all registrations should go for composition. You cannot select for particular one. Am I clear? This is second doubt that I have to answer. Third doubt. Because now I have one branch in Maharashtra and one branch in Nagaland or Arunachal Pradesh or Mizoram, Meghalaya, those states. Am I clear? Alright. And all India level I have to check turnover criteria. So should I check 1.5 crore? Because from Maharashtra perspective it is 1.5 crore limit. And from Mizoram Manipur?
75
lakh. So my turnover, total turnover is 80 lakh. See, if my total turnover is 60 lakh, then no problem because I am eligible in both. Okay. If my total turnover is more than 1.5 crore, then also no problem because I am not eligible at all. But my turnover is in between 75 lakh to 1.5 crore. If you look from Maharashtra angle, I am eligible. If you look from special states angle, not eligible. So which one I should take? Which one? Whenever there is a confusion in GST law, go conservative. Whenever there is a confusion in law, go
conservative.
See, for selecting scheme, there is a penalty. If you select scheme when you are not eligible, there is a penalty. If you don't select scheme when you are eligible, there is no penalty. I hope you understood.
Yes.
Scheme select kiya, jab tum eligible nahi ho, to penalty hai. Scheme select nahi kiya, jab tum eligible ho, to bhi penalty nahi hai. Because that is a choice. Selecting scheme is a choice. Yes or no?
Yes.
So give me conservative answer. From Maharashtra angle, it is okay, your turnover is 80 lakh, you are eligible. But from Nagaland angle, you are not eligible. So should I take scheme or should I not take scheme? Don't take scheme because from one state angle, it is not eligible. So conservative answer I am giving. If you are having business in both state, special state and normal state, your limit should be 75 lakh, not 1.5 crore. Hello? Maharashtra and Delhi? 1.5 crore because both states are having 1.5 crore. Meghalaya, Mizoram?
75.
There is no confusion. Confusion will come in your mind only when one branch is in normal state and one branch in special state. You should go conservative 75 lakh. Minimum you should select. Am I clear? So these are the three doubts that usually people get from composition, which are little advanced level doubt that I have taken. Okay? Can I go ahead? Yeah? Now, when we say turnover, okay? Turnover means sales, total credit side of your P&L account. Now one business can do turnover of these four items. Okay, these four items. Turnover shall include, first of all India basis, it shall include value of all outward supply, value of all, and there are four types of outward supply we can have. We can sell taxable commodity. Taxable commodity means the commodities which are taxable in GST. Hello? Alright. So it can be taxable sale. It can also be exempt sale. See, for checking eligibility, we are also taking into consideration exempt sale. Because sale is sale. Whether I am selling taxable commodity or exempt commodity, that doesn't make any difference. So I am selling fish. Fish is exempt in law. Potato, exempt in law. Bangles, exempt in law. Condoms, exempt in law. Sanitary napkins, exempt in law. Are you getting? So if I am a shopkeeper, I am selling all of these items. So my turnover is turnover, no?
Yes.
So they are saying don't only check taxable turnover.
Yes.
Check total turnover, aggregate turnover, summation. Mm-hmm. Hello? And aggregate means what? Aggregate means taxable supply. At the same time it is exempt supply. Am I clear?
Yes.
Now exempt supply can be of three different types. It is not written in composition, but it is written in definition of exempt supply.
Mm-hmm.
Hello? Exempt is not only exempt. Exempt means there are certain products which are taxable at nil rate. They are taxable, but the rate of tax is zero. Hello?
Yes.
So that is also exempt only, no?
Yes.
Still you will count. Okay? Not only exempt, okay. There are exempt supply which are exempt in notification. I will show you that notification after this composition scheme. Even non-taxable supply. So if there is one petrol pump, petrol is a GST product or non-GST product?
Yes.
But that petrol pump is selling other item also, like chocolate, biscuit, chips, water bottle. Hello? You have seen no big size petrol pump, usually they sell. In movies and all, usually, Hollywood movies technically, on petrol pump you get this consumables also. Alright, engine oil, okay, some car wash, some car related accessories, hello, repair and puncture, mechanic services. So petrol pump is providing all these activities. Yes or no? Petrol itself is not taxable. Petrol itself is?
Non-taxable.
But when you are doing multi-product, if you sell only petrol, you are outside GST.
Yes.
But you are now selling petrol as well as other item also. Okay. So while checking eligibility, whether you are eligible or not eligible. Okay. So last year you sold petrol for 90 lakh and other product for 60 lakh. Okay. So what some expert was having opinion, because petrol is non-GST item, petrol is non-GST item, we should not consider while checking eligibility. We should not take it into account while checking eligibility. So ignore this and look only this. 60 lakh. So 60 lakh is less than 1.5 crore or less than 75 lakh, so eligible. Government saying no. For checking eligibility, you need to consider taxable supply as well as exempt supply. And exempt supply can be of three types. Nil-rated, exempt and non-taxable. That means this should be included or this should not be included, you tell me. This should be included. So what is my total then?
150
lakh. Exact 150 lakh. Exact? Am I eligible or not eligible?
Eligible,
because turnover up to 1.5 lakh you are eligible. If I add 1 lakh here?
Not eligible.
So it will become 151 lakh. You will not get benefit of compositions. Am I clear?
Mm-hmm.
So checking eligibility, we have to see with this. Sir, what if I have export turnover also? So this is my P&L account. Okay, this is my P&L account. This is credit side. Buy sales, no?
Mm-hmm.
Turnover means buy sales.
Yes.
Okay, I have taxable supply 20 lakh. Shall I count it?
Yes.
Yes or no? And this is of financial year 18-19.
Mm-hmm.
We are in financial year 19-20, but we are checking turnover from
18-19.
Taxable supply 20 lakh included?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay. Exempt supply, any of these three types, okay? 80 lakh, is it included?
Yes.
Yes. I have export supply, export.
Yes.
Export, should I consider here?
Yes.
Yes, because that is also turnover, 30 lakh. Am I clear?
Yes.
30 lakh, shall I go ahead with this much?
Yes.
Okay? These are the items that I have to consider, okay? See, taxable supply, exempt supply, and even?
Export supply.
Okay, not only this, one more item I am telling you, even interstate supply. Interstate supply means from my state to another state. How much? Say for example 15 lakh. What is the total of turnover? 1,45,000. Eligible or not eligible?
Eligible.
Okay. If I make it 60 lakh, then 175 lakh not eligible. So there are four items in my turnover: taxable supply, exempt supply, export supply, and even interstate. Interstate is the fourth item here. Okay. Don't write it in bracket. This is the fourth item: taxable supply, exempt supply, export supply, and interstate supply. All these four items are included. Now here also student get confused. Very important point I wanted to mention here. I said interstate supply shall be included in a turnover. And one of the condition that we are going to discuss now, and casually we have discussed before also, that composition dealer is not allowed to make interstate supply. Mm-hmm. And then you will ask me, sir, here interstate supply is already given. Mm-hmm. Beta, this is from last year. Yes. Mm-hmm. For checking eligibility, we are checking last year turnover. Last year he can make interstate supply, no?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Current year he should not make. Mm-hmm. If you want composition in 1920, current year he is not allowed to make interstate supply. Last year he made interstate supply, that's okay. We are just checking turnover, whether he is eligible or not eligible. So for checking turnover, we can count interstate supply. So if I ask you, last year was he eligible for composition? Answer is no, because he is making
interstate.
Current year he is promising us, no sir, we will not do any interstate supply, because we, as a consultant, as a cost accountant, as a chartered accountant, we will tell our client, sir, last year aapne wo interstate supply kiya tha, current year mein mat karo. Why? Otherwise composition scheme will be withdrawn. Then you will say, I will not tell to government. Sir, if you don't do that, if you manipulate your data, first of all you cannot hide data from government. Why? Because you will put IGST. You have to put IGST. Without bid, without tax invoice, my truck cannot cross one state border to another state. And you are, as a composition dealer, you cannot issue tax invoice. Why? Because you have to issue only bill of supply. So gadbad ho jayega sir pura. You cannot hide it from government that you are making interstate supply. Are you getting this? And the moment you make interstate supply, your composition scheme will be withdrawn and you will fall in normal scheme. Are you getting this? And if you don't do it voluntarily, they will put penalty also on you. Okay. Hello. So am I clear with this interstate supply? Current year you are not allowed to make interstate supply. That doesn't mean in last year you cannot have interstate supply. Last year you can have interstate supply. Okay. Sir, this is my normal question, okay? Now you tell me, I'm making this sale, okay? 10 lakh rupees is my sale, this is my bill. And on this, I charge GST 1.8 lakh. Okay, this is my sales and this is GST, okay? 1.8 lakh. Total amount I will collect from party is 11,80,000. Are you getting? What is my turnover in this? Turnover? I collected 11,80,000. What is my turnover? 10 lakh is my turnover.
Yes.
1.8 lakh is a GST component.
Yes.
So they say, while computing turnover, don't consider GST component as your part of turnover. Yes. GST is not your turnover. GST is your liability. You took it from customer, you have to deposit with government.
Mm.
Are you getting this? Sure?
Yes.
So they say, from turnover you have to exclude any GST.
Yes.
Any
GST.
What type of GST we have in law? We are having CGST, SGST, UTGST, IGST, and SES.